What's going on, you guys? Kid Behind the Camera here.
Fritua's here.
Right there. And today is Wednesday.
Michael, that's not the intro.
No?
No.
We do more than that? Yes. Today is Wednesday.
And today we are playing Alien Isolation.
Today we're not doing nothing.
Michael, where are you going?
Use the bathroom.
We're not done with the intro.
We just did it. Today's Wednesday. Today we're up playing Alien Isolation. That's it.
Michael, that's not it.
We do more than that during intros?
Yes, we do more than that during intros. Guys, I think... And today we are cooking something.
Today we're cooking a very special treat. I don't want to tell you any more than that. It's a surprise. Today we're cooking.
Michael! We're not done!
Sorry!
Jesus!
Okay, let's wrap this thing up. Today, let's end it right here. Today is Wednesday. Look, I'm not stupid. I know the vlog, the intro is
continuing. I know, I'm starting to like wonder.
Wow, you have a brain that can do thinking? Was that insulting? Bridget went from... It was a joke.
So, Michael is upset because...
Why are you filming?
Because we're trying to eat healthier, and he's not having it. I can go make you emergency slices.
Yeah, okay. You know what? You filmed that last night too, didn't you?
Yes.
Last night, I was hungry, and I wanted some snacks. I wanted fast food. And Bridget brought me... Here's the clip.
Babe, I got your snack.
What?
Your emergency slices.
What the hell's that?
It's vitamins.
What the hell's that?
It's a cranberry pill.
So I asked Bridget to go get me a snack. She brings me apple slices, a vitamin, and a... What am I, 80? What is this?
No.
Okay.
Did you just chew that?
No, don't gross me out.
Oh.
What the hell is this?
A cranberry pill.
I was thinking more along the lines of pizza.
That's why I got you emergency apple slices.
What the hell is this?
I tried to peel,
How can you not peel apples?
I don't know why it's so hard, but for some reason I don't know how to do it.
Well.
So I need to get like a peeler.
Oh, thank you.
Are they good?
Yeah, it is.
I'm thinking about getting some emergency slices too.
What time's the pizza get here?
Michael!
Yeah. Seriously, apple slices. And freaking vitamins and cranberry pills and water. Oh my god.
Babe, I'm sorry. But it worked, didn't it? You felt better after those slices.
It did. Yeah, I was fine.
Uh-huh.
Today, this morning, she makes me a little plate with cottage cheese on it and the apple slices, and there's yogurts now. Can't I just get the new fried chicken taco from Taco Bell?
What?
You haven't heard about that?
I haven't heard about this.
Hold on, you guys heard about this? Taco Bell, which Grandpa actually has a history of like throwing up in their parking lot.
Oh my god.
They aren't coming out with a new, it's like a fried chicken taco shell chalupa. Comes out like the end of this month. Click like if you want Grandpa to try it. We haven't done any fast food reviews in a while. Click like, Grandpa's going to Taco Bell. We usually go to Burger King. We'll go to Taco Bell for the try. I can't even talk. Am I that hungry? Try one.
Take your tongue out.
All right. Was it a white and pasty?
Oh.
What is it?
That's a fungus.
What?
That's a fungus of the head.
Okay. So you're saying I'm sick in the head? Is that one way of saying it? Okay. Anyway, click like. What was I talking about? Click like. Grandpa will try the fried chicken taco. So just now, we were looking at the dogs. They don't even notice us through our own door. Can you see them right now?
Yeah.
Does Bella look at you at all right now?
Wait, yeah, I think she's looking at me.
Oh, we look like total liars now.
Wait.
She sees you, and so does Lazy.
Oh!
We look like a total pack of liars.
Why are you lying, Michael?
Hey, guys. Are you trying to get into this house? Oh, they just...
Bella's just like, yes.
I had okay, because I had a funny idea for a scene that the dogs weren't looking at us, and they started looking at us right after. We looked like total liars and fabricators.
Why are you trying to lie?
You saw it!
I'm just kidding.
Okay, we gotta cook. Before I get to the cooking of the vlog, because we are going to be cooking something healthy in just a second, before I get to that section of the vlog, I wanted to take the time to tell you guys some good news that we just got. Bridget just got off the phone with the vet.
I did.
Very good news about Bella, you guys. A lot of people have been asking her condition. We've been waiting all week for some test results to come back. We just found out the tumor on her face was a, what was it, type 2?
Yeah, it was a low grade 2.
A low grade 2 mast cell tumor, something like that, which means, according to her, it's got a very low risk of coming back, and the blood work came back with no cancer. So Bella is good to go, baby. Bella
has
no more cancer. I'm obviously a little worried because she had one here and then she has it here.
Yeah, we definitely gotta keep looking.
That's what she said, to keep our eyes open and check her like we've been doing to see what... You guys have been asking for an update, so Bella is... Do I say cancer-free?
I think she's cancer-free. She doesn't need chemo.
Yeah, last time she needed chemotherapy, this time she doesn't.
Yeah.
So that's very good news, you guys. No chemo for Bella. Just got it taken out. It is low. It's awesome, you guys. So that's the good news. That's what the vlog is about. Thank you guys for all your support and asking us about Bella. She's good. She's cancer-free. Now, let's take our asses in that kitchen and make a celebratory feast.
Yeah.
A feast fit for somebody healthier than me. It's a thin king. To celebrate our good news, I wanted to make us something pretty good for dinner. And I wanted to do something a little healthier today because everybody says, try healthier things, Michael, as if there's anything wrong with drinking a cup of grease when you're thirsty. So anyway.
I know. Oh my gosh. What is that?
So I blended up a Big Mac and used it as insulin. So what? So anyway, today we're going to cook something a little healthier. Everybody's been asking. Oh, by the way, Crown, I'm king of the kitchen.
Aww.
You understand you're in the presence of King of the Kitchen.
Yes, I do.
So, today, we are making, so was it on BuzzFeed?
Yes.
It was on BuzzFeed. It was a trending little thing about spaghetti, spaghetti squash?
Yep.
Some sort of spaghetti squash dinner. So anyway, right here, the first thing that I did was I took the spaghetti squash, went on down a line, and microwaved for 5 minutes. Now, we're just going to cut down the middle of it. And you don't want to cut off your hand. That's very important in this process. You want both hands when this is the dinner is over. Okay.
Whoa.
So, that was our first step. Now we are going to just straight up scoop all this crap out. Bridget, you want to open the trash can for me?
Yeah, this smells like pumpkin.
Hey, you're observant. You don't gotta film this. Just give me.
No, I'm filming this.
I chose the wrong spoon.
You want me to try? You look like you need help, King of the Kitchen.
Not today. King of the Kitchen requires more help. There we go. That helps.
Yeah.
We're just scooping all this crap right out of it.
Whoa.
Because it's not needed.
How many people thought we were joking?
What?
About healthy food.
Oh, yeah. All of them. I bet they were all expecting me to snap my fingers and it to turn into a Big Mac. Which, honestly, I'm thinking about, for the scene, going to get some Big Mac just to do it. No. That was my shot, you guys. So anyway, we're scooping all this out. That's first. It's garbage. You don't need it. The next step is you're going to take some olive oil and you're going to just do this with it. Don't worry, we're going to use some of that in a minute for the other part of it. A little bit of pepper. Person on the video used their fingers, but I'm not. We're using pink salt.
Aww.
So you grind up some fresh salt. What?
Nothing.
Okay, so you can do this. You flip it. Really rub it on that.
Aww. It looks so good already.
And
that be all, folks. Dinner's done.
You eat it. You
not really.
Is the oven ready?
No.
Okay, we'll be back, you guys. This is where we are right now. We're gonna put it in the oven. I can't cover it. You wanna cover the lens?
Cover the lens, Bridget. I've gotta go take a crap. Oh man, get the crown off me. This is really getting. Can't fix my glasses. Can't take the crown off. I gotta take a crap. I'm crowning.
Ew! Oh my god.
Yes?
Did you wash your hands?
Why are you filming me?
Because I'm a vlogger. I vlog.
Yes, I washed my hands the first thing before I even used the bathroom.
Ugh. Let's talk about the oil, you nasty bitch.
Yeah,
oh my
I did. God.
And it smells so
I
bad.
Did.
I gotta open the window.
Hey!
Michael! Stay so bad.
Why are you messing with me right now?
No.
You're a liar.
Oh, I want to throw up.
I wash my
did
hands.
Did you use soap?
Yes. I washed my hands twice now.
I don't even think you watched it the first time.
Will you just cover the lens up? We gotta cook. Alright, so we're going to preheat this. Now, me and Bridget don't know how long to preheat it for. We didn't look at the recipe, so the number is popping in my face. Now, that's how long you preheat it for. Because we didn't look. So we got it in there.
Whoa.
And when I said preheat, I meant how long we cook it for in the oven, not preheat it. We got some other stuff to do now. Let's get to cooking.
Wait, I just gotta tell you something.
Yes.
I don't think you're a nasty bitch.
Okay, I didn't care.
All right.
So, might as well, I was gonna cut to the next scene, but might as well just start it. So.
It was a joke.
The first thing you wanna do is unlock your stove.
It was a joke. What are you doing?
Nothing, joking. All right. No, I need that. Okay. Our next step is to cook our chicken. We're gonna go not low, but on 5.
Yeah, medium.
Yeah.
All
right. Our next step is to cook the chicken. So, tossing some olive oil right into the pan. And give it a minute to heat up, then we're gonna toss our chicken in. So Bridget, cover up the lens now so I can wait for the preheating to take. Why? Just do it. You're like flipping me off, by the way.
You
got, she got one middle finger over the thing. Why are you filming this?
Because.
We got really hype. You can see the it's turned off now. So we got real hype, we're like, all right, chicken time, yo, let's let it heat it up. And then we check on the recipe. This thing in the oven's gotta take 40 frickin' minutes.
Yeah, 40
so
minutes.
So we gotta wait out 20 minutes. It's like a run the clock situation before we can even start our chicken, so.
Oh my gosh.
There was any need to film that at all?
It was pretty funny. Let's check on this.
Yeah, that's the idea, Bridget. Should it be smoking and bubbling like
that? I don't know.
Our next step is just straight up add chicken to some olive oil in a heated pan. And we're just gonna cook this up. And I don't know, that's not really much else I can show you. It's chicken. We'll be right back. I said I'll be right back on the camera, Bridget. You're ruining my cooking dinner. My cooking video.
Okay, you know, okay, got it. Okay.
Our chicken is now out. Now we're adding a little more olive oil because a lot of it got taken out with that. And look, I didn't have time to dice up the onions, all right? So I'll just use all the onions, right?
Yeah.
Onions is onions.
Heck
so
yeah.
Now we are browning up some onions.
Whoa.
And I know Christmas is over, but I'm just gonna brown up these onions. Then we're going to add garlic and cherry tomatoes. We're gonna get to that in just a second. For now, we're browning this up. Bridget, wanna check on that?
Oh my God, it's on fire.
What?
Frank.
Garlic. We're doing a nice little bit of fresh garlic right to the onions.
And right to that, some of these red cherry tomatoes.
Oh yeah.
Lots of people cut them in half. I don't like cutting them in half because I like them to sear and pop. Save some.
A little more. I love seared tomatoes.
Right. I do too. Yeah, seared tomatoes, you guys. I hate tomatoes. Unless it's on like a sandwich or a taco or a burger. Or squished into spaghetti. Tomatoes are right. So, but I really love them seared.
Yeah, oh like my this. Gosh. They're so
and there might be a touch too many in this, but Bridget likes it. So we are just searing this like so. By the way, that's out. We forgot to tell everybody.
Yeah, and it's soft.
So let's just finish this up, and we'll be back in just a second. How are these looking?
Awesome.
They're pretty good. Can you hand me that knife over there, please?
What knife?
Knife.
This is a salmonella knife. Hang on.
I need to cut the lemon.
Okay.
Why can't I just have that knife?
Because it's a salmonella knife.
Okay, hand me the new knife.
Look at that.
Okay. What's that sound?
I don't know.
We get trains out here?
I didn't know that.
That's a new sound.
That is a new sound.
Cover the lens. This is the remaining steps for this part. So we add all of our chicken straight to it. Then a whole shitload of fresh spinach.
Whoa.
How many ounces is this exactly?
6.
Okay.
Recipe calls for 8, but I think that's enough.
Yeah, that's a whole bunch of fresh spinach right there, folks. So we're going to start cooking this down. Holy moly, dude. Also, salt, pepper, 1 cup of chicken broth, and some fresh lemon.
Oh my gosh, it's awesome.
Seed just popped down there. Get it, you little bastard. All right, you guys, here comes the crazy part. Because we're not using noodles, this is our noodle base. So, the thing said, take your, there you go. You take your 2 forks.
Oh my gosh.
Strip this.
Holy crap.
Strip this of its, quote, pasta.
Wow.
Look at that. Comes right up, Bridget.
Wow, that's really cool. Wow.
That is wild.
It really is. Jesus.
Wow.
That's neat.
You guys, this is so cool.
It really is, man.
Is the camera really capturing it?
Should I get closer? Yeah.
Okay, so, check this out.
Whoa.
Look at that.
That's cool.
And I assume you can turn this into spaghetti, all of that. Okay, you guys, here we go. We got some spaghetti squash over here. You just pour this over it.
Wow.
Now, do you want more broth, Bridget?
Yeah, I'll take a little broth. Oh.
Let me taste this, make sure it's broth and not just like straight up water. It's a good broth.
Nice.
Okay, so we got this. Sprinkle a little Parmesan cheese directly over it.
That's awesome.
And, folks, there you have it.
Well, that is so cool.
Try it for video, Bridget.
This is gonna be hot.
Yeah. We're also going to make ourselves some salads.
That's good.
All right, you guys. There you have it. That is something healthy that I've made. Can you believe it?
That's really good, Michael. Holy crap.
You want to sit it down and make your salad?
Yeah.
I'm covering the lens. Look at this. They're just like skin flaps now. This is what we're dealing with afterwards, folks.
Oh my god.
Let me tell you something.
It was awesome.
It's amazing how this passes for noodles.
I know.
Look at that, you guys. It's like, by itself is good.
Yeah, it tastes buttery.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
And people are like, you added a bunch of oil. Not to this one. We made another one off camera with no oil. And it's just as buttery. It's pretty crazy. So
good.
Wow. Before we get out of here, I did want to talk about the fact that Grandpa just called me off camera. Really, really happy. I don't think I've heard him this happy in a long time. It was pretty crazy. He was thrilled because Roseanne, I hope you guys have seen the show Roseanne. You haven't.
It's a great show.
You need to watch it.
I kind of grew up on it.
Roseanne followed Angry Grandpa, and apparently she and her whole family are like really big fans.
Oh my gosh.
And Dad is thrilled to death. She's tweeting about going dancing with Dad, us flying out to Hawaii to see. It's...
Oh my gosh.
I can't put it into words how much of a fan Dad is of Roseanne. Angry Grandpa is of Roseanne. He cried when Dan had the heart attack. I mean, he cried at the finale. It's like, the way I am with Harry Potter, Dad is with Roseanne. It's his favorite thing in the world because it was kind of a reflection of our lives growing up. We dealt with, you know, poverty and, you know, family bickering and just a family dynamic that she was able to capture. And it was one of the only things that we watched as a family together. Every time Roseanne would come on, we'd be in front of the TV. So that was awesome, you guys. Tweet Roseanne. It is at The Real Roseanne. Tell her thank you for making Grandpa so happy because she really did, dude. It was amazing. And I'm really amazed right now. It's cool as hell. She followed me. She followed Bridget. She followed Kim. She followed... Wow. Who knew? It's a part of my, part of me is like, wow, because that's my childhood.
I know, it's absolutely insane.
Every time I take a flight, I'll put on, because usually it's in the morning times and it comes on like Lifetime or something, the women's channel, and I will look for Roseanne while I'm on the plane. It's like so awesome that she did that. So thank you, Roseanne. Remember, tweet her, tell her thank you for this. Time for us to do the outro. Guys, this pasta was freaking delicious.
It was really good.
I need some more of this.
The only thing I would change about it is I would add more garlic, because I love garlic.
I want to try this with like a spaghetti pasta, like marinara sauce.
Tomorrow?
Well, that's going to be it for today, you guys. Thanks for watching. Had a pretty good day.
It's been a really good day.
Dinner was really good. Had a good time.
It was really good.
The stuff with Roseanne was freaking crazy.
I know, my gosh, I love Roseanne.
It's like, I told you guys before, I just can't express it how much my whole family loved Roseanne growing up. It was like one of the only shows we watched as a family.
Yeah,
so it's pretty crazy.
Same here.
So it's pretty crazy that Roseanne is a fan of us. Like, wow, because she can't be as big of a fan of Dad as we are of her. So
yeah, I know, right?
Pretty awesome. Dad's really happy. Thank you, Roseanne, for making that happen for Dad. That's awesome. What a good day. Good dinner. Good time. Remember, go tweet Roseanne. Tell her thanks for making Grandpa happy. That's going to be it.
Yeah, he's so happy, guys. It's...
Like.
Subscribe.
Favorite.
Follow on everything. Bridget West.
And that's it.
I love you guys so much.
I love you more. The face I was making was way too...
I gotta give him another one then.